Bobby Darin was a great American singer, songwriter, and actor who had become a universal presence in pop entertainment in the late 1950s and 1960s. He was born on May 14, 1936, in the Bronx, New York. He didn't have a lot of money growing up. Bobby's real mother was Nina Casotto, but he never discovered who his real father was. Throughout his childhood, he was told by his family that his parents were Sam and Polly Casotto, who were actually his grandparents. Sam Casotto was an associate of the crime boss Frank Costello, and he died in Sing Sing prison. Polly, a former performer, encouraged Bobby to become a star like Frank Sinatra. Darin was born a thin and sickly child. He had fought through several bouts of rheumatic fever, which had permanently damaged his heart. But that would not stop him from becoming a big star.
I was taking a bath.
By the time he was 16 years old, Bobby Darin was well-versed in several musical instruments. He started out playing in his high school band and got his first gigs at dances and school functions. One summer, his bandmates booked a gig at a resort for the summer, where he found that he had a knack for not just music, but comedy as well. After high school, he briefly attended Hunter College, but decided to leave college to start his music career. He launched his professional music career writing songs for the Al Don Music Label and eventually landed his own record deal with Atco. In 1958, Bobby started off his music career with the bang, releasing his lighthearted song, Splish Splash, a song that reached the top five of the pop charts. Quickly became one of the most popular teenagers of his generation, with songs like Queen of the Hop. He also scored to big in 1959 with two songs, Dream Lover, arguably his best, and most famous song, Max Tonight, which got number one on the Billboard Top Hit. It won him even a Grammy Award for Best Record of the Year. Darin also won a Grammy for Best New Artist.
Darin continued to enjoy great popularity throughout the year, moving from the concert stage to the big screen. He starred in the romantic comedy Come September with his future wife, Sandra Dee. Darin continued his acting career and eventually won an Academy Award for his World War II movie, Captain Newman. Around this time, Bobby also established himself as one of the top acts in Las Vegas. He became a popular crooner, just like his hero, Frank Sinatra. Yet Darin drew inspiration from a much broader musical background and was a more relentless and ambitious performer. Darin became such a force in Las Vegas that he supposedly helped started Wayne Newton's career.
On the music charts, Darin had even more of his songs become top hits, like Beyond the Sea and You Must Have Been a Beautiful Baby. He even had success with his take on country music with hit songs like Things and You're the Reason I'm Living, a song wrote for his wife, Sandra Dee. Darin had his last major hit during the final years of his life with his take on folk song, If I Were a Carpenter. Around this time, his marriage with Sandra Dee was about to end. Bobby Darin died on December 20th, 1973, of a heart failure in Hollywood, California, at the age of 37. He will always be remembered as one of the top singers during his time.